Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is your station where you've been watching and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and I've been taking you through chemistry. Today we are going to look at enthalpy changes in physical and chemical processes. Specifically, we are going to look at heat of neutralization or enthalpy of neutralization. Welcome to this lesson. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to state what is enthalpy of neutralization. You'll also be able to determine molar heat of neutralization. And lastly, you'll be able to draw an energy level diagram to represent molar heat of neutralization. So what is neutralization? This is a reaction that involves action of an acid and a base, and the results are salt and water. The salt and water formed are neither acidic nor basic, or alkaline for that matter. That's why the reaction is referred to as a neutralization reaction. From this example, we have hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide, and the results are sodium chloride and water. The ionic equation for that reaction, the ions involved in a neutralization reaction are hydrogen ions from the acid and hydroxide ions from the base, which gives us water, 1 mole of water. So what is enthalpy of neutralization? Energy content of neutralization. This is the molar heat or the energy change that occurs when 1 mole of a substance is completely neutralized, or that is when 1 mole of hydrogen ions from an acid is completely neutralized by an alkali. So we have hydrogen ions from the acid and hydroxide ions from the base. 1 mole of each gives us 1 mole of water. And from the example that we had earlier, it gives us 54.6 kilojoules per mole. The negative sign there implies that the reaction is exothermic. So how do we determine enthalpy of neutralization? Let's consider the following. Hydrochloric acid reacting with sodium hydroxide solution. So when sodium hydroxide is added to hydrochloric acid, the thermometer indicates an increase in temperature. This is because heat energy is lost to the surrounding. Once again, there is an increase in temperature, and this is because of the heat energy lost. The products are sodium chloride and water, and the beaker feels hot when touched outside, and this confirms liberation of heat energy to the surrounding. So let's look at this example. 50 centimeters cube of 1 mL hydrochloric acid was added to 50 centimeters cube of 1 mL sodium hydroxide solution in a plastic beaker. The temperature of the resulting solution was raised by 15.5 Kelvin. Determine the heat of neutralization. Into brackets, we have the specific heat capacity. We have the density of the solution, which is 1.0 grams per centimeter cube. So how do we work out to be able to get the heat of neutralization? Write the ionic equation. From the equation, ionic equation, we determine the enthalpy of neutralization by multiplying the mass of the solution, the specific heat capacity, and the temperature change. So what is the mass of the solution? Remember, we have 50 centimeters cube of hydrochloric acid being added to 50 centimeters cube of sodium hydroxide solution. That means the total volume is equivalent to 100 centimeters cube. When we multiply the volume by the density, we get mass, which is 100 grams. Multiplying that with specific heat capacity and temperature change, there we have the enthalpy change or the heat of neutralization. Remember, we have not put into consideration molar heat of neutralization. So how do we determine the molar heat of neutralization? Calculate the number of moles of each of the reactants. In this case, we have 1 mole being in dissolved in 1,000 centimeters cubed. Where do we get this information from? Remember, our acid was 1 m, so we interpret it to be 1 mole dissolved in 1,000 centimeters cubed, but we only used 50 centimeters cube of the solution. So how many moles did we use? When you multiply that using the correct formula learned previously in mole concept, you get 0.05 moles. So when 0.05 moles of hydrogen ions from the acid are completely neutralized by hydroxide ions from the base, liberates 5,670 joules. So then how many or what or how many joules will be liberated when 1 mole is produced? By dividing the molar heat, the heat produced by the number of moles, you get 113,400 joules. Dividing by 1,000, that gives us 113.4 kilojoules. How do we represent this in an energy level diagram? Commonly, we have energy on the y-axis and reaction path on the x-axis. Since it is an exothermic reaction, the product, which is water, has less energy than the reactants, and the energy liberated is shown. That is, the enthalpy change for that reaction is 113.4 kilojoules. Did we understand this concept? We do so by answering the following questions. What is enthalpy of neutralization? Question 1. Question 2. 100 centimeters cube of 0.5 m of HCl acid was added to 100 centimeters cube of sodium hydroxide in a plastic beaker. If the temperature of the resulting solution was raised from 25 to 31.4 degrees Celsius, calculate the molar heat of the solution in kilojoules. And lastly, represent these in an energy level diagram. I would like also to point out that it is important for us to use a plastic beaker since it does not conduct heat to the surrounding. If we use a different material, that means it will gain some heat and it will affect the heat of neutralization. For more information concerning this topic or the content, you can refer to KLB Secondary Chemistry Students Book 4, which was published by Kenya Literature Bureau. Or you can refer to Patel Secondary Chemistry English Press Limited. You can as well as contact us through the following links. You can send us an SMS. You can reach us on our Facebook page, Erimu TV, or you can give us a tweet at @erimu_KE. You're welcomed. See you in the next lesson.